Alistair is six, but he can barely read. Though he has normal vision, his brain can't process what he sees or writes on a page. Letters can become mixed up or inverted.
What have you written again? That's not right, is it? What should you have put? Yes, how does the bugger?
Tests here have shown that children with Alistair's form of dyslexia can be helped. When we look at an object, the brain uses one eye to process what we see. It's this reference eye Alistair is lacking. Well, now, by using a special pair of glasses with one of the lenses blacked out, they can train children to develop a reference eye. Already in just 2 months, Alistair is improving. But success with 11-year-old Michael is even more dramatic. 2 years ago, he couldn't read anything. Now, by using the glasses, he's developed so that his reading age matches his own.
To start with, he couldn't play any games on his own. He belonged to Boys Brigade, which he couldn't take part in anything like that because he just couldn't read for himself. So since he's had the treatment, he's been able to join into all sorts of things, really.
Just wearing the spectacles isn't enough. There has to be backup help from reading specialists as well as parents and teachers. But there's no doubt the treatment offers hope for many dyslexic children.
About a third of dyslexics, we believe, can be helped by this treatment. There are two-thirds, therefore, who have other problems, either in addition to or instead of this problem.
How important is it, in your view, that other hospitals should be doing this work as well as yours?
Naturally, we believe it's very important that they should at least try out this technique so that we can find out whether they find that it's useful in the same way as we do.
A handful of other hospitals are now following suit, helping to give children whose problems might otherwise have been submerged a chance to read and write normally. John Andrew in Reading for Thames News.